Right, it's that time of the week again, that time of the month again. So I'm off to do one of the heavy shopping runs. And just for today, I thought I'd bring you along with me. Edited highlights. So I anticipate 2 15-kilo bags of sacks of cat dog food in there, a 10-kilo sack of cat litter in each of the Clarice Feet's Tassen, and various shopping in this big old fishing box that I got from a car boot sale once. That ends up almost too heavy to carry into the house when I'm done. Right, so off we go then. I'll put you into a mount. I've got a back mount on there as well, which has a good view of the trailer. I'll keep giving you little views of that. Let's go then. The speed bump seems to have woken up the local yappy dogs. You get used to the noise. I find zigzagging through the back streets, or sort of tacking through the back streets, is much preferable to being on the main road when I'm towing this thing. I go slowly, I'm wide, I have the right and I assert my right when necessary, but no point being an arse about it. I wonder if this guy's deaf. I don't know. What Copenhagen eyes call a desire line. Thank you. here we are onto Bispham Cliffs on the Wild Coast Cycleway. You've seen this before on my little shopping trips. It's about 6 p.m. now. It's been a sweltering old day and there's some light cloud come over now, some haze on the sea. You can't see the wind farm, you can't really see the Lake District very well, which you often can. But it's taken the heat off the day, which is nice. There are worse supermarket runs. Thank you. they always put the area outside of a supermarket on a slope, so it's probably runs away. That is very full and very heavy. That's got the dog food in and more shopping on top. That's got the cat litter in and the laundry stuff and what have you. I haven't put any weight in the front because this basket's falling to pieces. So I've just got bits and bobs in there. And here we go, the important part of the journey. Getting home. I'm not going the seafront way home. I go home through the houses. It's about 3 miles, I think. Teenage drama. I didn't really do that when I was a kid. I had my own angst. Well, then how much do they want for this then? Don't put the price in the window. Grand maybe. They're probably asking 3. That bungalow that I just focused on used to be the home of Violet Carson. Initianopoulos from Coronation Street for the British. Bungalow right opposite our house is the former home of Jimmy Clitheroe, the Clitheroe kid. Tomlinson, Scouser extraordinaire, was actually born about 50 yards from our house as well. Ian Anderson, Jethro Tull, another kid from the neighbourhood. There used to be quite a few of the cast of Coronation Street live in this area. Once the first one or two of them came, a few more came. They used to get the same train in from our local little station, and it became known as the Coronation Street Special. Then the fans started getting it deliberately, so they had to have a car set instead to take them all in to Manchester every day. Manchester's about an hour away. This is a steady drag uphill now, so I'm going to put you down again. This is Bispham Village Centre. Bispham was the oldest thing around here. It's the mother church to Blackpool even. It's derived from the bishop's homestead, Bispham. But in true Blackpool style, the history has basically been wiped out. Another little drag up this hill coming now. So, as we arrive in my glamorous unloading spot by the bins, the noise of the main road in the background, there we are, all intact, no incidents, nothing to report, all is well. I've got everything in the house now. Ooh. Thanks for coming along. Slightly unusual video, but it's for most of the world, this is cycling. And I have no time for those small, that small element in cycling who think this isn't proper cycling and we're not proper cyclists. I invite them to ride this brick home from the shops every week while I ride their carbon fibre wonder bike. So, there'll be more videos later in the week. I've got a busy week refurbing the Chilton and the two old Rally and Humber and some 20s. They're all stacking up now and they all need doing. So the videos hopefully will keep coming thick and fast.